So as we have our chapter adaptive filtering or adaptive filters here, this is basically a focus on to the practical aspects having non-stationary into the account here. And therefore for the practical applications we have been developing the FIR, standing for the finite impulse response filters here. So whatever the filters we have defined, discussed for the study of the adaptive type of the filtering, considering the non-stationary aspects here, those have been implemented into the direct form here. And as we know that the lattice filter is having important advantages over the direct form structure as far as the computational complexity and simplicity are concerned here. That is why here we are going to have consideration of the design of adaptive lattice type of the filters here. So here the development will start with the derivation of the gradient adaptive filter of the lattice type. Here we can abbreviate it to as capital GAL, standing for the gradient adaptive lattice for the adaptive linear prediction here. Now as we have the background into the previous chapter, where we had the linear prediction and the optimum linear filters, the FIR lattice filter is parameterized in terms of the reflection coefficients. The reflection coefficient here we can denote by capital gamma suffix J. Jth reflection coefficient here we can refer to as. So the output of the Jth stage of the lattice filter, here we can consider for the Jth ordered forward and backward prediction error. In the previous chapter we have referred linear prediction and optimum linear filters, the forward direction as well as the backward direction for the prediction purpose into the linear fashion here. So for the corresponding forward and backward prediction errors, we have the mathematical equations here. See, for the forward prediction error we denote E suffix J and to the power we have plus sign, positive sign here, and this is of small n, the discrete time representation given by x of n added to the summation k is equal to 1 to small j, or the multiplication of the filter parameters A suffix J of k multiplied to x of n minus k here. Whereas for the backward prediction error we have the mathematical expression E suffix J of n, and to the power of E we have minus sign, a negation sign here. So this is equal to x of n minus j added by the summation k is equal to 1 to j, or the complex conjugate of the filter functions A suffix J of k into x of n minus j plus k here. So here the coefficients as we have denoted A suffix J of k in the first equation on the right hand side second term here. So these are the coefficients related to the reflection coefficients through the step up and step down recursions here. Now we have a consideration of several different ways to design a lattice filter for the linear prediction here. So either forward or the backward direction here. So these various ways include the sequential minimization of either the mean square forward prediction error, the mean square backward prediction error, or the Berg's error here. The Berg's method also we have discussed in the previous chapter here. So let us take one example where we have the sequential minimizing of the Berg error. This can be denoted by zeta suffix j of n, and to the power for Berg error representation we put capital P. So this is equal to the expected value of the mod squares of the two terms, which are nothing but the previous two equations representing the jth order forward and backward prediction errors. So the RHS here is expected value of, first of all, mod square of Ej of n positive added by mod square of Ej of n negative here. So this is going to result into a set of reflection coefficients. The reflection coefficients are denoted by capital gamma suffix j. So for the Berg error, here we denote capital gamma suffix j to the power, here we have representation of capital B. So this is given by minus 2 multiplied to the ratio, where numerator is capital E of expected value of, we have E suffix j minus 1 of n positive, in multiplication to the square bracket, which is a complex conjugate of E suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative here. The denominator of this ratio is expected value of mod square of E suffix j minus 1 of n positive added by mod square of E suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative here. Now, as an alternative to this particular solution, let us have consideration that a gradient descent approach for minimizing the Berg error using the update equation given by, we have the update equation, hence for this particular capital gamma representing the reflection coefficient, updated one, the left hand side here we denote by capital gamma suffix j of n plus 1. So this is equal to, for the previous step, capital gamma suffix j of n minus mu suffix j partial differentiation of the Berg error zeta suffix j of n to the power, we have capital B, and this partial differentiation is with respect to the complex conjugate of capital gamma suffix j. So from the lattice filter update equations, we have the forward and the backward prediction errors denoted as, first of all, for the forward case, E suffix j of n positive, this is equal to E suffix j minus 1 of n positive added by capital gamma suffix j multiplied to E suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1, E is negative here. Next to that, we have E suffix j of n, and here we have negative here, this is equal to E suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1, E is negative, added by the complex conjugate of gamma suffix j multiplied to E suffix j minus 1 of n, and E is positive here. Now we have the derivative from the previous equation of the update. So here we have the derivative form, we have del del complex conjugate of gamma suffix j for the Berg error zeta suffix j of n to the power, we have capital B, this is equal to the expected value of the two terms added together. The first term is E suffix j positive of n here multiplied to the complex conjugate of E minus suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1 added by complex conjugate of E suffix j of n, E is negative here, multiplied to E suffix j minus 1 of n, and E is having the positive power here. So finally the update equation will take the form, here I write, so gamma suffix j of n plus 1 is equal to gamma suffix j of n minus mu suffix j multiplied to the expected value of, here I write, E suffix j of n, E is positive, multiplied to the complex conjugate of E suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1, E is negative, and this is added to E suffix j of n, E is negative, which is complex conjugate, multiplied to E suffix j minus 1 of n, and E is positive here. So this is nothing but the steepest descent adaptive lattice filter, and as we know that E suffix j of n positive and E suffix j of n negative having complex conjugate will depend on the reflection coefficients gamma suffix j of n. So making the substitution from the previous two equations to the earlier, we have satisfaction to the first order difference equation given by gamma suffix j of n plus 1 is equal to, the RHS will hold the two terms here, the first term is square bracket having 1 minus mu suffix j multiplied to the expected value of mod square of e sub j minus 1 of n positive added to the mod square of e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1 e is negative here multiplied by the square bracket is completed and it is further multiplied by gamma sub j of n here whereas the second term which is in addition to this one is equal to 2 times mu sub j expected value of e sub j minus 1 of n positive multiplied to the complex conjugate of e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative here. So if it is consideration of the stationary aspects here, the reflection coefficient gamma sub j of n will converge to the Berg solution. So it will be denoted by gamma sub j to the power we have capital B. And here we have the term multiplied to the gamma sub j of n that is less than 1 in magnitude. Here we can denote the magnitude less than 1. So magnitude is in terms of mod. So mod 1 minus mu sub j multiplied to the expected value of mod square of e sub j minus 1 of n positive added by e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative mod square here. So therefore in turn the constant onto the step size, the step size here we have denoted by mu sub j will be the limits. So it will be greater than that of the zero but less than the ratio where the ratio is 2 divided by the expected value of mod square of e sub j minus 1 positive added by mod square of e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative here. Now due to the expectation in to the previous outlined equation, if you have outlined for the update equation we have shown, which is the steepest descent adaptive lattice filter here. So there it is a limitation to use since it is requiring that the second order statistics of the forward and backward prediction error be known there. And if we adopt the LMS approach instead of the steepest descent adaptive lattice filter, so we get the new update equation. So this is just by replacing the expected values with the instantaneous values here. So the new update equation form is capital gamma sub j of n plus 1 is equal to capital gamma sub j of n minus mu sub j multiplied to, here we have e sub j of n positive multiplied to the complex conjugate of e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1, e is negative, and this term is added to the complex conjugate of e sub j of n, e is negative, which is multiplied to the e sub j minus 1 of n, e is positive here. So this is the gradient adaptive lattice filter, which we can abbreviate to as capital GAL. Here it can be noted that if x of n, the input signal, if is a wide sense stationary, so that time the reflection coefficient will converge into the mean, and here the provided condition is that the step size denoted by mu sub j satisfy the limit in between 0 to the ratio where the maximum value is 2 divided by the expected value of the addition of mod squares of e sub j minus 1 of n e is positive and e sub j minus 1 of n minus 1 e is negative. Now the summary of the gradient adaptive lattice we can give into a tabulated form. Here we require the parameters P denoting the filter order, mu sub j denoting the step sizes where j will have the values assigned 1, 2, 3 and so on up to the filter order small p here. The initialization we can make for e sub 0 of n positive equal to 0, e sub 0 of n negative also equal to 0. The gamma sub j of 0 also equal to 0 for j is equal to 1, 2 and so on up to the maximum filter order denoted by small p here. The computation for n is equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on and j is equal to 1, 2 and so on up to p will compute a, b and c given by this particular expressions here. So a is e suffix j of n, e is positive, this is equal to e suffix j minus 1 of n positive added by gamma suffix j of n multiplied to e suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1, e is negative here. The b expression is where we have e suffix j of n, e is negative, computed as e suffix j minus 1 of n minus 1 negative added by the complex conjugate of gamma suffix j of n multiplied to e suffix j minus 1 of n, e is positive here. Whereas the most important last equation is the update equation. The first two equations A and B were for the forward and the backward prediction errors. Now the update equation, here it is denoted gamma suffix j of n plus 1 is equal to gamma suffix j of n minus mu suffix j multiplied to the addition of the two terms. The first term is e suffix j of n positive multiplied to the complex conjugate of e suffix j of n minus 1, e is negative. Second term is complex conjugate of e suffix j of n, e is negative, multiplied to e suffix j minus 1 of n positive here. So this is what the tabulation of the summary for the gradient adaptive lattice here. Now, facing the difficulties involved while determining the step sizes, that is really very very important for satisfying the convergence constraint here. The gradient adaptive lattice algorithm is typically normalized using the time varying step size given by, we have mu suffix j of n is equal to beta divided by d suffix j of n here. Instead of the minus sign, this should be equal to sign here. So in this representation, beta is a constant and beta is greater than 0 but less than 2 here, and capital D suffix j of n that we have in the denominator of the right hand side is the estimate of the denominator, and the estimate that is frequently utilized in computation is D suffix j of n is equal to 1 minus lambda in multiplication to the summation for the index variable k is equal to 0 to small n, or lambda to the power n minus k multiplied to the square bracket that has the first term mod square of e suffix j minus 1 of k, e is positive, added to mod square of e suffix j minus 1 of k minus 1, e is negative here. So in this expression, the lambda is the representation in the exponential place to be a weighting factor. So lambda is greater than 0 but less than 1 here. So the use of this particular representation for implementation provides the advantage that the estimate is d suffix j of n evaluated efficiently with the recursion here given by the mathematical equation d suffix j of n plus 1 that is equal to lambda times d suffix j of n added to 1 minus lambda multiplied to the square bracket that has addition of two terms. First term is mod square of e suffix j minus 1 of n plus 1, e is positive, and the second term is mod square of e suffix j minus 1 of n, e is negative. So here we have completed our topic.